flag. Gentlemen, please remove your hats. The Fremont High School Band, under the direction of Mr. Doug Bogatz, will play our national anthem.
Christine Broden and her 7th grade English class at Fremont Middle School. And may I just say, thank God for middle school teachers, because I have no idea how they do it. During my time in this class, I was able to reread and study The Outsiders, a late 1960s book about two different groups stereotyped as long-haired scruffy greasers, and from the other side of the tracks, the wealthy, preppy socius. The novel covers the different events that come along with the conflict between these two sides. Most of us graduating here today have read this book at some point or another. From the perspective of a 7th or 8th grader, the quotes and lessons from this famous book might not have seemed significant as they do after 12 years of schooling. You may recall the quote, "Stay Gold," said by Johnny, a lead character in the book, who is dying, to a protagonist, Pony Boy, who is struggling internally. But what does it mean to stay gold? Does it have to do with money? Does it have to do with winning awards? I believe gold moments represents moments of innocence. But as we head off to become adults, how do these moments pertain to us, or are they something we have lost already? In our 4 years together, the class of 2022 has been through so many unpredictable and honestly weird events. The first being the historic flood of 2019, which devastated so many homes and businesses here in Fremont. It put us essentially on an island from the rest of the state, and the country saw how we were unable to help one another recover, just as any strong community would. And yet, in all of this chaos, we saw each other strive to find bold moments to carry us through. Not even a year later, along came this thing called a pandemic that completely took over our lives. It is still haunting us as a main story on national and local news. Our sophomore year was cut short and moved to online schooling, catching up with friends and being taught lessons over Zoom, often having technical difficulties and not seeing the faces of your classmates. To make matters worse, spring sports were canceled and an entire season was eliminated. Even more disappointing, we were all forced to quarantine and had to stay home almost all of the time. We went through the ridiculous toilet paper shortage and the separation from the people we love, but still we aspired to appreciate the gold moments. In our junior year, we were more fortunate because we were able to go back to in-person learning, unlike a lot of other schools. Sadly though, for the rest of the year, everything was restricted. Not having lockers took away our little snippets of time with friends. Limited attendance at extracurricular events meant no student sections and small audiences. We also were not allowed to have homecoming or pep rallies. Oh, and the icing on the cake, we all had to wear those scratchy and annoying masks. We can no longer read emotions or see familiar smiles. We won't even talk about how we pretended like we could hear what others were saying, especially teachers, but that might have been on purpose. Somehow, we came together as a school, community, and class to pull through this difficult time and come back to make the best of our high school years, all the while searching for more precious gold moments. We survived the pandemic just in time to worry about the humanitarian crisis overseas. With social media and different online platforms, it is so hard to know what's real and what's not. And let's face it, most of us have been confused the whole time. It is so scary to think about, especially as we have to figure out our plan for the next 4 years, all while trying to find who we are and what we stand for. Here's where the quote, "Stay Gold," comes in. Through all of this turmoil, hardships, and difficulties, somehow our class has found a way to make the best of it. We came up with creative ways to embrace these carefree moments that make each of our lives more meaningful. I mean, think about it. We stood at the back of football student sections as freshmen and worked our way up till the front row. We started winning games, meets, matches, performances, tournaments, and competitions, proving each year we were only getting better. We celebrated 4 Halloweens, Thanksgivings, Christmases, and Easters with our friends and family. Classmates formed study groups, and then we celebrated our successes and took a collective sigh of relief. With each new semester or quarter, we met people we had never seen in the school before and became their friends. We applied and received scholarships, we stressed and relaxed for finals. We even shared lunch times together. These are the moments that will stick in our minds. These are the ones that really matter. We won't remember the score of each game or the grade on every test, but we will remember the fleeting, joy-filled, carefree moments, that the ones that cannot be held. And one day, we will tell our kids and grandkids about these innocent, meaningful moments. For the other half of my experience at school and career, I have the pleasure of being a part of Daniel Moran's dual language kindergarten class at Washington Elementary. The majority of kids come into kindergarten with little to no knowledge. They may know their ABCs and can count up to 20. However, by the end of the year, they are counting up to 100, writing full stories, even some learning multiplication, not just in English, but also in Spanish. I noticed through all their learning how they express themselves with such pure joy. I saw constant giggles, bright smiles, imagined play, continuous excitement, and wide-eyed amazement. They only know gold moments. Their vision is only spotting gold. They live in a gold world, which is where we all started. I think it is clear through the passage of time, and especially these past 4 years, that the world is not all sunshine and rainbows. But I feel as we grow, it becomes easier to let these adventures slip by us. As hard as it can be, we must slow down. Look at the sunset a little longer. Pick the flower. Listen to the rain. If we can take anything from this address, although it might sound backwards, let's all try to be like the kindergartners and stay gold. Congratulations to you all again. Best wishes to your future journeys, and go Tigers.
Buenas tardes y bienvenidos a la graduación de la clase 2022. Es un placer estar dando este discurso hoy. Primeramente, le quiero dar gracias a Dios, las familias, maestros, maestras, entrenadores, amigos y todos los que nos ayudaron a llegar a este mundo. Sin ellos, nunca estuviéramos aquí hoy. Hoy, como muchos de nosotros aquí, logramos esto por la motivación de nuestra cultura migrante. Creciendo, viendo a nuestros padres trabajar duro todos los días para sacarnos adelante. Y por eso les doy gracias a mis padres y a todos los padres que hicieron lo mismo. Quiero que sepan que valió la pena. Hoy ha llegado nuestro momento. Hoy nos convertimos en ciudadanos del mundo. Hoy es el día que comienza nuestra vida. Hoy el mundo espera que nos convertimos en el futuro que nuestros padres nos aspiran a ser. Hoy no es un día normal. Dejamos ir todos nuestros sueños de infancia y entramos en el mundo real. Hoy extendemos nuestras alas y decidimos volar. Hoy es el día que nos convertimos en el sueño americano, sin olvidar de dónde venimos. Gracias. Y para despedirme, clase de 2022, sí se pudo. Our next speaker will be Taylor McKay.
Commencement ceremony at Fremont High's class of 2022. Thank you all for being here today to celebrate this occasion with us. First off, I would like to say congratulations to my classmates on graduating. We will all be missed. From the moment we entered the high school as a class, we've made an impact. The upperclassmen, for the most part, respected us because of what we were accomplishing, everything we did in our academics and activities, and the younger generations of the Fremont community looked up to us from the start. I believe we have repaid our community in every way possible. We have represented better than any other class, and we will not be forgotten. But it is our job to not forget where we came from. 6 years ago, I came to this school district because I had big basketball goals and I knew a couple of kids here. I made those dreams reality, and I grew up with those kids, but the school in this town came to mean so much more to me than what it did when I first arrived. My experience at Fremont was probably fairly unique, because of the drive from where I made each morning and the amount of times my name was in the newspaper, but I know that I was not alone in working hard each and every day. This class made hard work in school and our activities seem less like a job, which made time fly that much faster. I have to say, this day came a little too fast for me. I did not fully comprehend how close we were to graduating until last weekend, but I was forced to see the countdown of the days we had left. When it hit me, I was a little sad, but that feeling was quickly overcome with fear when I received emails from Mr. Socorro reminding me to write this speech, and I had not even started. In fact, this may have been the only thing I ever procrastinated during my 4 years, but I like to think that it was okay because I had such a good experience here that I did not want it to be over just yet. To my classmates, thank you for being a huge part of that. Fremont is a place where everyone comes together, and I believe our class was the best example of that, especially in this last year. With that being said, I know a lot of you are eager to leave this town, but I encourage you to remember the people here that impacted you and the lessons you've learned. Over the last 4 years, we've been taught to strive for excellence, to be kind and generous, to be leaders, to ask questions, to work together and encourage one another, to run fast, to respect everyone around us, and so much more. As a class, we're known not only for our achievements, but also for the types of people we are. Although we may have different interests and ideas, this class is full of good, genuine people who respect and care about each other, our school, and our town. Otherwise, why would we have shown up every day? It is our job to stay true to ourselves and our community and find and create more people like us in the world as we move on from high school. Among us, we have some students that are staying in Fremont, some that will go as far as the East Coast, and some that are heading overseas for their future plans. I feel that every student here has been prepared for what we may face in the future. Parents, families, and teachers, I largely attribute that to you, and we thank you for all that you've done for us. This class is going to go on to incredible things. I encourage all of you to take advantage of each challenge you will face in the future, and keep finding ways to achieve your dreams and stay on your pursuit of happiness. Lastly, to Fremont High's class of 2022, to my parents and family, and to my teachers and coaches, thank you. I try to say thank you every day, but it was not enough. You have all impacted my life in so many ways, each one shaping me into the person I am today. Coming here was the most special opportunity for me, and these years have been something I will never forget. Roll Tigers forever. And now Mr. Socorro will lead us in a moment of silent reflection.
Please join me in a moment of silent reflection as we remember family members and friends who are no longer with us on this special day of celebration. May our memories of these loved ones provide us strength for our journey ahead. Now, please welcome the Fremont High School senior vocal students under the direction of Mr. Mark Harmon, accompanied by Mr. Elliot Lockwood, as they perform For Good.
Thank you.
now Superintendent of the Fremont Public Schools, Mr. Mark Shepherd, will introduce our presentation of scholarships and honors.
Good afternoon. It gives us great pleasure this afternoon to announce the academic achievements and scholarships earned by many of our graduating Fremont High School seniors. More than 100 of the students seated before you have been declared recipients of scholarships. These awards, if carried out to their fullest potential, have a total value of nearly $6 million. That's a lot of zeros. This amount does not include any loans or government grants. We believe this is a fantastic accomplishment for the class of 2022. We know that other members of this class may still receive scholarships, and that there are some who have received scholarships that were not reported by the date for publication. Students who reported awards by printing deadline of April 22nd are listed in the commencement program. Would all students of the class of 2022 who receive scholarships please stand and be recognized. Our first student reader is Mia Wagner.
In October of 2020, about 70 members of this class competed in the National Merit Scholarship Qualifying Test. About 50,000 juniors qualified to take this test across the United States. Of those students, only around 16,000 received the National Merit Semifinalist Honor. In order to advance in the competition to become a finalist, students had to fulfill several requirements that included submitting a detailed scholarship application and presenting a record of very high academic performance. All winners of about 7,500 National Merit Scholarships are being chosen from approximately 15,000 finalists. Mackenzie Kirby received this distinguished scholarship as a finalist for the class of 2022. Mackenzie, please stand and be recognized. Our next reader is Elise Estadillo. Over 30 years ago, Fremont High School initiated an academic achievement award program. Any student who has earned a minimum grade point average of 3.7 for any two consecutive terms in grades 9, 10, 11, or 12 is eligible to receive an academic achievement award. The level of the award indicates the number of years the student has earned the academic achievement award. Will the graduates who have qualified as level 1, 1-year winners of this award please stand as your name is read? Please hold your applause until all names are read. Allie Bishop, Madeline Byrd, Jennifer Kamey Neighbors, Austin Cassidy, Porter Chandler, Annabelle Chan Perez, Saul Contreras, Zachary Dine, Kendall Freeman, Augie Frost, Rodrigo Garcia, Antonello Ganeka, Victoria Godfrey, Quinn Gossett, Juliana Hernandez, Emmeline Hernandez Castellanos, Ismarana Hinosa, Kayla Johnson, Raimundo Juarez Karnak, Aime Lopez, Sharon Mejia Morales, Gabriela Mercado Guerrero, Landon Mueller, Sierra Nelson, Jacob Newell, Azaisha Noose, David Ortiz Guigo, Alina Pop, Erindira Romero, Drew Sellen, Lena Sandusky, Jaden Smith, Taylan Tidro, Zane Zastero. Two-year winners, please stand as your name is read. Justin Acuna, Marlene Alonzo Lopez, Diana Batista Revilla, Adriana Campos, Jennifer Escobar Sheridan, Emma Foster, Bethany Lackey, Talia McEnroy, Jacqueline Nadir, Lexi Montoya, Joel Moore, Liliana Newell, Zachary Manit, Jeanette Peterson, Samantha Cruz, Megan Rawl, Hunter Rich, Courtney Roberts, Jennifer Salas Duran, Gavin Teat, Naomi Vincente Loarca, Jesus Villasenor Garcia, Brady Walter, Brandon Wellness, Sam Wolf. Please be seated. Level 3 3-year winners, please stand. Juan Alvarez, Grace Flick, Maya Bolden, Keithan Cudley, Tasia Doris, Francisco Garcia Jr., Tania Gleason, Kaylee Harrington, Marina Harrison, Grant Hevlin, Henry Ebenthal, Ella Hofer, Ty Yeager, Jonathan Lede, Peyton Linus, Jacqueline Martinez, Lucas Montepique, Clara Moreau, Kylie Phillips, Aubrey Bieber, Jacob Santora, Sarah Shepherd, Ty Sundquist, Talia Tenney Sierra, Maria Tolliver, Ashlyn Tucker, and Micah Vincent. Please be seated. Our next reader is Micah Moore.
This is receive the cum laude endowment, please stand.
Vicente Gonzalez, and Carter Waters. The next reader will be Laura Zunes.
Please remain on stage until all of the awards have been presented. This year, we had a tie in the voting, so we actually will honor six students today. Today's awards are Best Citizens. This award emphasizes scholarship, exemplary conduct, and assumption of citizenship responsibility. The first Best Citizen is Carter Waters. Carter is the son of Joel and Krista Waters. Honors include cross-country state champion, track state champion, honor roll, academic letter winner, cross-country letter winner, track and field letter winner, Nebraska School Activities Association Believers and Achievers Award. While at FHS, Carter participated in track and field for 4 years, cross-country for 4 years, National Honor Society, and Student Council. Carter is a member of First Lutheran Church. Scholarships that Carter has received are University of Alabama Presidential Scholarship, Fremont Credit Professionals Scholarship. Carter will be attending the University of Alabama, majoring in accounting. The second Best Citizen is Mallory Schleicher. Mallory is the daughter of Michael and Michelle Schleicher. Honors include FHS Honor Roll, FHS Softball Letter Winner, FHS Track and Field Letter Winner, Academic Achievement Letter Winner, Heartland Athletic Conference All-Academic Softball Team, Heartland Athletic Conference All-Academic Track Team, Lincoln Journal Star Class A Softball Honorable Mention, Omaha World Herald Class A Softball Honorable Mention, U.S. Bank Believers and Achievers Local Award Winner, Heartland All-Conference Award, Fremont Public Schools Art Show Featured Artist, Nebraska Coaches Association All-Star Game Player, Daughters of the American Revolution Good Citizen Award, FPS Board of Education Outstanding Achievement Recognition. While at FHS, Mallory participated in softball for 4 years, track for 3 years, choir for 2 years, letter club for 4 years, Heartland Athletic Conference Leadership Cadre, 3 years, Varsity Cheer, 2 years, Youth Leadership Academy, Comprehensive Plan Workshop, National Honor Society, Spanish Honor Society, and Mallory serves as the historian for the National Business Honor Society. Scholarships that Mallory has received are Youth Leadership Academy Scholarship, Pinnacle Bank Outstanding Leader Scholarship Award, Altrusa Scholarship, FDA Scholarship. Mallory will be attending the University of Nebraska Lincoln, majoring in advertising and public relations. Our third Best Citizen is Brady Millar. Brady is the son of Scott and Heather Millar. Honors include Honor Roll, Academic Achievement, Academic All-Conference Honors, Free Sport Letter Winner, National Honor Society Member, Business Honor Society Member, Spanish Honor Society Member, Business Student of the Year, Cum Laude with High Distinction. While at FHS, Brady participated in football, basketball, baseball, track, student orientation staff, student ambassadors, athletic youth camp counselor, letter club, and FCA. Brady is a member of the Fremont Alliance Church. Scholarships that Brady has received are UNL David Distinguished Scholarship, Haynes Hill Memorial Scholarship, Sam Heineman Business Student of the Year Scholarship, Nebraska Coaches Association Country Inn and Suites Student Athlete Scholarship. Brady will be attending Texas Tech University and studying agribusiness. All-around student. This award emphasizes scholarship and participation in a variety of activities. The first all-around student is Haley Newell. Haley is the daughter of Matt and Tammy Newell. Honors include National Honor Society, President of German Honor Society, National Thespian Society, Tri-M National Music Honor Society, Brian L. Anderson Fine Arts Student of the Year, Scholastic Art and Writing Gold and Silver Key Award Winner, Honor Roll, Academic Achievement Award, lead role in the Music School Oklahoma Outstanding Vocal Music Student Award. While at FHS, Haley participated in track, softball, varsity cheer, dive team, varsity choir, chorale, symphonic band, jazz band, theater, FHS Letter Club, First Lutheran Youth Church Group, Spodassa. Scholarships that Haley has received are UNL Regents Scholarship, Fremont Area Art Association Hazel Key Memorial Scholarship, Pat Murphy Track and Field Scholarship, Bridget and Joyce Key Scholarship, Millikan University Merit Scholarship, Millikan University Honors Scholarship. Haley will be attending Millikan University in Decatur, Illinois, and studying arts technology. The second all-around student is Macy Bryant. Macy is the daughter of Dominic and Lindsay Bryant. Honors include honor roll from 2016 to present, Heartland Athletic Conference honorable mention for basketball, Class A honorable mention for basketball, Class A second team honors for basketball, NSAA Academic All-State Award, four-year varsity letter winner for basketball, National Honor Society, Spanish Honor Society. While at FHS, Macy participated in Unified Bowling, Letter Club, Book Club, Student Government, Student PDIS Group, Student Orientation Staff Member, and Daily Announcement Reader for 4 years. Scholarships that Macy has received are James Ebers Scholarship, PEO Star Scholarship, Fremont High School Letter Club Scholarship, UNK Regents Scholarship. Macy will be attending the University of Nebraska at Kearney. Honor Key. This award is the highest award which emphasizes scholarship, loyalty, leadership, and achievement. The Honor Key recipient is Taylor McCabe. Taylor is the daughter of Ryan and Dana McCabe. Honors include Honor Roll, Academic Achievement Award winner, National Honor Society member, Spanish Honor Society member, four-time Super All-State Player Honors, All-Conference and Academic All-Conference Honors, Nebraska All-Time Career Leader for three-pointers made, ranked number 88 nationally by ESPN, the only player ranked from Nebraska, the only Class A guard to ever score 2,000 points in a career, has school record for three-pointers for game with 9, season with 107, and career with 389. While at FHS, Taylor participated in basketball, cross-country, track, Fremont Letter Club, PAC Leadership Program, St. Francis Borgia Church Member. Scholarships that Taylor has received are the University of Iowa Athletic Scholarship, and Taylor will be attending the University of Iowa and studying civil engineering. Ladies and gentlemen, I present to you this year's honor students. At this time, it is my pleasure to present Mr. Mark Shepherd, Superintendent of the Fremont Public Schools.
Graduates, faculty, parents, and friends, Fremont Public Schools and the Fremont High School are proud of our commitment to seeing students achieve to their maximum potential. That commitment is recognized by the number of students involved in dual enrollment and advanced placement courses. These courses not only allow a student to gain a head start into their college experience, but these courses are provided at a greatly reduced rate, allowing the students and their families to save money. This summer, our seniors will have a unique opportunity to further their education at no cost through Metropolitan Community College. If you have not done so, please look at this opportunity that has been offered graciously by Metro for this summer. Beyond the scholarships and awards for academic areas, this year we've had a number of students compete and represent Fremont and Fremont Public Schools at state, regional, and national levels. The class of 2022, over the past 4 years, have been part of more state championships and runner-ups than any other class in our recent school history. This year, we have not one, but two State of Nebraska Gatorade Players of the Year, Ellie Dahl in cross country and Taylor McCabe in girls basketball. Ellie and Taylor. One thing that we know at Fremont Public Schools is that we need to do more in the way of recognizing success and celebrating with our students and their families. This year, we've had the opportunity to celebrate many accomplishments in a variety of activities and areas. Several weeks ago, the Fremont Public School Foundation honored our students and their teacher mentors who achieved cum laude with high distinction. As has already been mentioned, this year, we have, to my knowledge, our first ever National Merit Scholar. Congratulations to Mackenzie Kirby, as has already been mentioned, on achieving this prestigious award. Please stand, Mackenzie. We also, throughout the year, celebrate with our students who have signed with colleges and universities to play sports and take their talents to the next level. Earlier this spring, we hosted an industry signing where four individuals signed with local businesses to further their education and training at no or very limited expenses to them and their families. At this time, I take great pride in honoring all individuals that have chosen to enter the armed services and represent our school and community as they serve our country. 2 weeks ago, seven individuals signed with the armed services to commit to serving our country during a celebration that was attended by District 15 State Senator Lynn Walz and Nebraska Commissioner of Education, Dr. Matt Bloomstead. Would the members of the class of 2022 that are entering military service please stand so we can recognize and thank you for the service you're about to embark on. Thank you.
of the Board of Education. On stage, we have John Lepickson, Todd Hansen, Pam Murphy, and Mike Peterson. Our sixth board member that could not be here today is Terry Sorensen. And we're the lucky ones that get to give you your diplomas, and we're almost as excited as you are. So today is a day I want you to reflect on all that you've achieved. It's a day to celebrate, and it's a day to look forward. Really, I mean, you've heard speeches and you know this is the pinnacle event. So it might be a piece of paper and it might be the walk across the stage, but it brings together a lot of things for you. The other thing I want to remind you to do, and I've heard it a couple times in the speeches, is to thank those people who helped you get here. They're probably the people who are sitting here supporting you, and they've been supporting you the whole journey. So it wouldn't have been, it would be much more difficult without them, so make sure you say thank you. And I've talked to a couple of you over the last week or so, and I know there's a little bit of nervousness about the next step that you're ready to take in the ceremony. So I'm going to try to help you with that in a minute. And I've heard people talk about the challenges of this class, and it's true, you've been through stuff that maybe everybody before you hasn't, but I've also heard, and I completely agree, it's probably for the better, because you're some of the kindest, strongest, sort of most sympathetic, wonderful people. So keep that up. I think this probably, these challenges have served you well in the future. And my advice to you is to continue to be flexible and resilient, because you're not always in control of the circumstances, but you are in charge of your attitude and your effort. And sometimes hard things will happen in your lives, but almost everything can be overcome if you just keep trying. Okay, so back to the next event that we're gonna do. You've all earned the honor to walk across this stage because of the efforts you've made. So I want you to hold your heads high, and I want you to walk confidently, and most importantly, I want you to smile. We're celebrating. Everybody looks better when they smile. We're gonna take your picture, and your parents want you smiling in it, so I want you to remember to smile. On the rare occasion that somebody trips or sneezes or something else that you didn't want to happens, they tell you to just pick yourself up, ask for help if you need it, put your smile back on, and keep going. Because the most important thing today is just to get your diploma, and we're going to get that done. I'm also going to give you a little secret. I've done this for 15 years, and I have almost never seen a graduate have a problem. But once in a while, the adults do, so keep your eye out for that. So we have a plan, so if anything doesn't go perfectly, we're going to get through it. And on behalf of the board, I want to tell the Fremont Senior High Class of 2022 that it is our sincerest wish that as each of you moves forward, you achieve success and you create happiness. Good luck. Woohoo, you did it. Congratulations.
We will now read the class roll for the class of 2022 and present them with their diplomas. Justin Acuna. Alondra Adame. Alian Aguilar. Jesse Alarcón Nunez. Marcus Allen. Laura Alonso Zunex. Marlene Alonso Lopez. Abigail Alvarez. Juan Alvarez. Kenny Alvarez. Elias Anderson. Christian Andrade Rodriguez. Yeah! Marissa Anthony. Henry Avalos Bautista. Emily Ayers. Adelie Bachman. Amara Baker. Tyson Baker. Mackenzie Bannister. Diana Bautista Redilla. Zachary Beam. Jeremy Bernal de la Sancha. Grace Blick. Maya Bowman.
Jerry!
Annie Bravo Torcios. Leonard Brester IV. Macy Bryant. Audrey Butterfield. Madeline Bird. Freddie Calvo Perez. Jennifer Kame Navas. Adriana Campos. Dalila Cardona. Antonio Castellanos Arisa. Animal Chan Perez. Porter Chandler. Emma Clark. April Hahn. Kelly Hahn. Saul Contreras. Paloma Corrugero Estrada. Caitlin Cram. Grace Cruz. Felix Cruz Bernal. Keithan Cudley. Ellie Dahl. Zachary Dine. Galat Du. Lucy Dillon. Tasia Doris. Haley Dowdy. Enrique Duarte. Jennifer Escobar Servin. Ismael Estrada. Orlando Estrada. Elise Estadillo. Madison Everett. Hayden Ferdinand. Tilly Fernow. Alexander Field. Mason Filter. Mark Fleming. Alexander Flores. Ernesto Flores. Luke Follette. Emma Foster. Leslie Garcia Aguilar. Woo! Francisco Garcia Jr. Yeah! Roberto Garcia Jr. Arnold Garcia Urbano. Manuel Garcia. Rodrigo Garcia. Ismari Hill. Antonita Jacob. Tanaya Gleason. Victoria Godfrey. Juliana Godinez. Alyssa Godwin. Ainsley Goble. Enrique Gonzalez. F.A. Gossett V. Miguel Huarcas Forte. Kimberly Gudiel Godoy. Luis Guillen Juarez. Destiny Hepcock. Greg Hammond. Emma Hansen. Naomi Carter. Kaylee Harrington. Joshua Harrison. Marina Harrison. Noah Heineke. Aiden Helgenberger. Jocelyn Hernandez. Juliana Hernandez. Emily Hernandez Castellanos. Grant Hevlin. Henry Hebenball. Grace Hires. Yukina Higashi. Mason Hill. Isamar Inohosa. Ella Hofer. Alana Henniger. Julia Hughes. Miriam Huss. Leticia Inorreta. Ty Jager. Carson Jesse. Kayla Johnson. Skylar Jones. Damon Jordan. Miguel Jose Chica. Raimundo Juarez Carmen. Cameron Cavan. Isabella Keaton. Miranda Kaiser. Derek Kyle. Mackenzie Kinney. Mackenzie Kirby. Savannah Kirby. Isabel Puthi. Mia Kanigi. Jared Nolenberg. Jackson Foreman. Cassiana Pradaville. Kenny Krieger. Jonathan Lede. Aaron Ladd. Avery LaFavor. Denise Longo. Kelly Lamont. Justin Leon Calderon. Mason Limbaugh. Marcos Inante Garcia. Angelina Lockhart. Aime Lopez. Eliseo Lopez. Trista Lott. Carlos Eduardo Lux Ramos. Peyton Lyons. Skylar Mackey. Christian Madura. Sinai Martinez Rodriguez. Jacqueline Martinez. Taylor McCabe. Hunter McClure. Skylar McDuffie. Jacqueline Meader. Andrew Menninger. Marissa Mahaffey.
Let's go!
Sharon Mejia Morales. Alejandro Melesio Jr. Benjamin Mankey. Gabriela Mercado Guerrero. Cody Messerschmidt. Kaden Meyer. Zachary Myers. Brady Millard. Isabel Miller. Nolan Miller. Elena Mokler. Mia Molson. Lucas Montefecchi. David Montes. Lexi Montoya. Joel Moore. Micah Moore. Edward Moran. Anthony Moreno. Caleb Morgan. Clara Morrow. Landon Mueller. Devin Mullen. Janice Nelson. Sierra Nelson. Nicholas Nemec. Haley Newell. Jacob Newell. Lillian Newell. Samantha Newell. Zachary Nanette. Macy Norris. Jennifer Ochoa. Kelsey Olson. Matthew Ondrachek. Morgan Ondrachek. Karen Orellana Aragon. David Ortiz Cuico. Emma Petrowski. Nancy Perez Tapia. Jeanette Peterson. Logan Peterson. Josie Pettis. Kylie Phillips. Aubrey Pieper. Kylie Pitt. Isaac Pisano. Alina Pop. Connor Porter. Isabel Prado. Lillian Prendergast. Ramirez. Giselle Ramirez. Leonardo Ramos Jose. Viviana Ramstino. Megan Rayo. Tyler Rayo. Peyton Remington. Jaden Wrench. Ariannette Escendiz. Justin Reyes Mendoza. Hunter Rich. Alexander Reeson. Landon Riffle. Misael Rivera Cabeza. Philly Rivera Cabrera. Courtney Roberts. Cruz Robles. Ernesto Robles. Mercedes Robles. Maria Rodriguez. Erendira Romero. Ellison Ross. Yasakan Sakhan. Ashton Sagehorn. Jennifer Salas Duran. Shermaine Salas. Jasmine Salazar. Alejandro Salome Garcia. Mandela Sanchez Marino. Isaiah Sanchez. Naomi Saravia. Emma Shear. Mallory Schleicher. Julianne Schmidt. Micah Vincent. Mia Wagner. Steven Wagner. Rena Walkenhorst. Brady Walter. Ariana Washington Amin. Carter Waters. Brandon Wellness. Brock Wentz. Nathan Wheeler. Kyra Wickman. Grace Williams. Landon Wynn. Ryan Winter. Sharon Worthy. Samuel Wolf. Madeline Busk. Daniel Zapata. Diego Zarate. Erwin Zarate Otero. Sierra. And now, Ellie Dahl will give our closing speech for today's ceremony.
Good afternoon. My name is Ellie Dahl, and I have been given the opportunity to present this closing speech to you today. First of all, I would like to take some time and thank everyone who has made an impact on our lives and shaped us into who we are now. To all the teachers, parents, coaches, principals, counselors, and administrators, I can say with total confidence, none of us would be here today without the help of each and every one of you. It has been easy for us to go through high school with focused, busy minds set on the task right in front of us. But let's take the time now to truly sit back and acknowledge all we have accomplished together. This class is special in many ways, and if you haven't noticed, we have made a big impact on the school and community. Through the many sports state championships, to fine arts awards, to academic successes, we have left a mark and set a high standard for other classes to look up to. We didn't do it alone, we did it together, and that's what makes it special. The endless weeks of waking up early for school, going to after-school activities, and then working on loads of homework has made it all worth it to be able to say, we made it. As classmates and friends, we have made many memories that will stick with us for the rest of our lives. Has truly gone by so fast. It seems like just yesterday, we were freshmen, walking in endless circles around the lecture hall, hoping we would end up in the right hallway. We all have moments we will miss, such as convincing our teachers to take mass breaks just to shorten class time, the many football and basketball student sessions. We got a cheer up, and let's not forget about the bus and cookies we all ate at lunch from the Titan Den. Then there are the moments we won't miss as much, such as the stinky girls' restrooms, the endless John Baylor sessions, and the awful music at our school dances. All these moments have made our high school journey memorable. With this being said, it is now time to move forward and create new memories. It is time to take the next step and not just dip our toes outside of our parents' safety blankets, but leap into the waters and ride the waves that are before us. We have made it this far, and it is exciting to know all our hard work can be applied to the new chapters we will start. I hope we go out with open eyes and hearts and do our best in whatever we set our minds to. Each of us have our own goals for the future, but no matter what we do, let's be the best we can be at whatever it is. Whether that means you become a brain surgeon, a stay-at-home mom, or even a garbage man, you better be the best garbage man you could possibly be. I wish you all the best of luck. To the class of 2022, congratulations, we will be missed. Thank you. And now Mr. Socorro will give the principal's final remarks.
Seniors, please stand. Move your tassels to the left side. Thank you for attending this year's graduation ceremony.